In this video, we're going to take a look at steel wire armoured glands, something we've worked with in the workshop, as well as in the installation theory element of your exams, and it can be as simple as identifying one of the elements of the glands. Now, we're going to look at a BW gland. BW means it's inside or in a dry environment, in order that we can identify all of the elements. So the gland I've got in front of me here is BW20, and you can have things like BW20S, BW25, BW40, and it's all about the diameter of the gland. So if we get it out of the packet. So this is a BW, so an inside gland, and it's 20. Every packet that you open has two of everything. So in other words, so we can make off both ends of a steel wire armored cable. So let's have a look at what we've got. We've got two shrouds, okay, within our packet. We'll move these to one side because they're often called the wrong name. So while I move them out of the way, think what you might call these in college settings. So I'll move those out of the way. And then we've got this here. So we've got our gland nut. So I'm going to wind that one off. And then we've got our gland body. So if I separate off the lock nut as well, so we've got that part here. So we've got our gland nut, our gland body, and you notice this knurling or roughed area here, and that's the bit that the armouring sticks into or gets trapped between when we're making it off. And these are all made of brass. So we've got a brass gland, gland nut, gland body. We've got a lock nut, of course it's 20 mil because this body here is also 20 mil. And when we say BW20, we're talking about the diameter of the actual gland itself. So there we have a 20. So if we were knocking a hole out of a box, it would need to knock out a hole that also is 20, 25, 40, or whatever we need to take out compared to my gland. When you see 20S, exactly the same. So the gland itself is a 20 mil diameter, but the body itself is a lot smaller. And then we've got this here. We've got our lock nut. It could be a lock ring. So we've got a lock nut, 20 mil lock nut. And have you thought about what this might be called? It certainly isn't called a banjo. It is not a musical instrument. I cannot play any songs on that. For your exam purposes, that will be known as an earthing ring, and again made of brass. On site, I totally understand they're going to call it a banjo, and I did for the entire time I was there, but the exam won't. The exam will call that an earthing ring. We've got two shrouds. We're going to have two gland nuts, two gland bodies, two lock nuts and two earthing rings within a pack for our steel wire armored gland if it's a BW, an inside style of gland. The packs themselves have a chart on them more often than not, talking about, first of all, the cross-sectional area of the conductors. So we're talking as small as 1.5 millimeters squared, all the way down on this pack to 400. We could go all the way up to 1,000. So that's our cross-sectional area of our conductors. And across the top here, we have the number of conductors within the cable. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10, etc. Now, we're likely to be working in college maybe with a 2 or 3 core cable. And let's imagine it was 2.5, 2.5 mil, and it's 3 core. Hopefully we can see that it says 20S. So we'd want for an inside gland, it'd be BW20 and S. As I just said earlier, all it means is the actual gland body is slightly smaller than this BW20 to accommodate that style of cable.